Good day, everybody. Connor McIver with SantaClaritaGunTraining.com. I am, of course, bringing you another episode in our podcast, actually the longest running shooting podcast here locally for Santa Clarita Valley and Los Angeles counties. Today we're going to talk about the third firearm safety rule, and we had the first two covered on previous episodes, and these are things that we stress when we get out there and we start training people with regard to guns and firearms. And again, all types. We can take somebody that is just contemplating purchasing a gun or a firearm. We could take them from being totally uncomfortable and really not loving it to loving it. We can do that slowly, of course, through a series of processes that we put in place that basically build one tenet upon another. So you'll start off with just the safe handling, and you can take that and give that to your family, friends, loved ones, those people in your periphery and in your sphere of influence. Because the worst thing that could happen with any gun or firearm is when it gets handled by people that don't know what they're doing, and then things happen and people end up getting hurt, and that damage usually runs incredibly deep. Plus, typically, there could be a criminal component imposed with whatever tragedy strikes during that sort of an event. One of the things I will tell you is you have to be prepared, and I do believe preparedness is the key to life, if you can, of course. That's why I go to the gym. That's why I always hone my shooting abilities. That's why I'm always using my manipulative care with regard to any gun or firearm system that I'm using. And that's why I study up and I continue to keep current in all of my walks of life, what I do. Now, we do have a great shooting cadre here in Santa Clarita Valley. We do host most of our training at a place to shoot. We also have other, a more private range as well, but a place to shoot really is just fantastic. I do really like the people that run the place, and they do take very good care of the clients out there. One of the things I will tell you again, and stressing, you know, these making sure you're safe and you handle each gun as if it's always loaded. That's the first rule that we covered in previous episodes. All guns are always loaded. The second rule is make sure you keep the finger, your finger, off the trigger until your sights are aligned on the target you intend to shoot. That's number three. Number two is never allow the muzzle to cover anything you are not willing to destroy. That second rule we covered in a previous episode. Now we're going to talk about keeping your finger off the trigger. Now, of course, all guns are always loaded. Just a quick recap, that is giving the gun system or firearm system the respect it deserves. I can take a pistol or a rifle and I can show you 100% without question that that gun is unloaded. There are no bullets in the chamber. There are no bullets in the magazine. There are no bullets within, well, as far of a distance as I choose there not to be. And you'll be able to verify it, but I'm not going to take that. I'm not going to point it at you. I'm not going to joke around with it. I'm not going to play cowboys and, well, other people, cowboys and criminals. I'm not going to do any of that. I am going to always respect it and keep it pointed in a safe direction, even when it is unloaded, even when it's verified. So I'm now treating that gun as if it's always loaded. Now, number two, keeping your muzzle pointed in a safe direction. That's the business end of the gun. So you do have your muzzle. That's where the bullet comes out of. And again, you want to keep that always pointed in a safe direction. Even when you're working on it, even when you're cleaning it, again, it's important. Don't ever take advantage. And if you are going to cover something, then you should have intention to destroy that something. Again, more respect. Guns don't kill people, folks. People that make mistakes, mishandling of weapons, guns, or people that are, well, intent on using it to harm or protect themselves, that's when things, people get hurt. And whether it's a good shooting or a bad shooting, people are getting hurt, right? Even deservedly so, even if the person that takes the shot believes that they're immediate defense of their life, there's no other way they could go. Well, you know the story. All right, so the third firearm safety rule that we talk about in class, as we're teaching everyone, the super high-speed, low-drag folks and the people that are brand new at this, we do talk about keeping your finger off the trigger until your sights are aligned on the target and you intend to shoot. Now, you'll watch movies, you see TV shows, you see how these actors, when their gun's up, they're on people, they have their finger right on that trigger. The dangerous thing about that, the most dangerous thing is most of these trigger presses are only 4, 5, 6 pounds. If you have a fancy gun, something that's been, well, doctored, if you will, smoothed out, compensated, made to be even smoother than it was out of the factory box, and they do this, an armorer can do this, they can take a gun and they can file things down and make it even smoother. You can also get a different trigger assembly, so it doesn't take as much pressure on the trigger to make the gun go bang. In that case, you watch these movies and these people have these guns up on people, and the people at the receiving end of that are only a couple pounds away from, you know, severe bodily harm or death. So, what I always say, what we say in class, what we taught with the police department is your finger is alongside the frame unless you're shooting. Unless you are actively shooting, your finger stays alongside the frame off that trigger. And if you've watched some of the blooper reels and other videos, you'll see what happens when that finger is on that trigger at times when it's not supposed to be. People get started, people are giving their speech or talking or trying to explain about this particular gun or the firearm or how great they are and how wonderful they've been and all the wonderful experiences they've had and how fantastic. So they're doing all of this, yet they have a live gun in the classroom and they're trying to explain it and their finger's on that trigger. And with a lot of these single fire weapons, ones that are cocked, like your Glock, M1911A1 types, your Browning high power types, where it's only when that hammer is back when that weapon will engage and work. There are some other weapon systems, gun systems that are called double action. So you press that trigger straight to the rear. After you press that trigger straight to the rear, the gun goes bang. And then that next press of that trigger is a lot less than the first. So that's a double action auto. That's going to be double action, then it's going to convert to single action after that. Either way, you're only a few pounds away from discharging the gun. So you have to be careful. So you're going to keep your finger off the trigger until your sights are aligned on the target and you intend to shoot and you are shooting. That's active firing. There is no speed difference, and I'll fight anybody on this. There's no speed difference from alongside the frame to on that trigger. Or it's so minute, it's not going to make a difference at all. But the safety that it imposes or disregards by not doing it, by keeping your finger on that trigger, well, it's completely something it doesn't have to be. It's totally outside. And it's incredibly dangerous. My suggestion is always keep your finger off the trigger until your sights are aligned on the target and you intend to shoot. This has been the third safety rule. Along with the other two, all guns are always loaded. Never allow the muzzle to cover anything you are not willing to destroy. And finally, keep your finger off the trigger until your sights are aligned on the target and you intend to shoot. And then we'll have number 4 next week. This has been SantaClaritaGunTraining.com. I am Connor McIver. I will tell you, we have a fantastic program in place. When you're ready, let us know. If you don't have a gun, don't have a firearm, you're above 21, and we can take care of that. That's just a little bit additional, but then you'll be able to shoot whatever you want, and we'll be able to show you how the system works. And we can take you from somebody that's never touched or handled or fired a gun, all the way to doing very, very well, even better, and then moving past that. We can take somebody that's an expert marksman, sharpshooter, we can bring them in and also build them, make them better as well. It's like a coach in anything. If you want to go to the gym, you might know how to lift, but I'll tell you, working out with a coach at the gym, I have never been more sore, and I lift every day, and I lift heavy, and I lift long, and I'm committed, and I'm focused. But when I get that coach in there, that personal trainer, they whip me up something awful. And it's very interesting for me. And I think that applies to other areas in life as well. I'm a big advocate of coaching. I'm a big advocate of going to somebody that knows more than you and learning from them. You wouldn't want to hire a financial advisor if they weren't millionaires. It wouldn't make any sense. If they're a financial advisor, that means their stuff is perfectly aligned and they're the best to advise you because their portfolio is incredibly strong. Same thing in business, the same thing in the gym, the same thing in life. You definitely need to get some good coaching. And I believe if you have the right one in all different aspects, you're going to be able to outperform yourself if you decided not to use coaching. I'm Connor with Honor. Thank you so much for listening in to today's podcast, SantaClaritaGunTraining.com, and our third firearm safety rule. We'll be back next week with number 4. When you're ready to sign up, just go to SantaClaritaGunTraining.com and hit the Contact Us button. You'll be able to fill out the form. We'll give you an itinerary, let you know when our next classes are, give you a price list, and tell you what the options that you have will be. No ego, no testosterone-filled instructors, just people that really want to teach you the right way to handle guns and firearms and build off of that platform. Be safe, everybody. Connor with Honor, over and out.